Hey everyone, I decided to do a video series of my chronicles of my bus. Bought it from Shadyside High School in Shadyside, Ohio. Bus number 7 for anybody that ever rode on it. It's a 91 Bluebird. And my intention is to make this thing into a camper. I've been watching videos on YouTube for a long time and I decided to make it a project of mine. So I'll take you along on my journey. Not step by step, because I actually have the seats taken out already, and I'll show you what I've done so far. So there are the seats that came out of the bus. So if anybody needs a bus seat, get a hold of me. I decided to take the old rubber and plywood off, clear down to the metal floorboards, because of basically headroom here. So taking the half inch plywood off that's there and the rubber off that's there, I'll treat the bottom because some of it's rusted from road debris, and I'll put new plywood down. And I'm not sure about the flooring I'm gonna put in yet. I'm kind of winging this as it goes, but here's what I'm talking about. You can see in the back here that I got that cleared down to the metal. Took the plywood out, pieces of plywood. It's rusty. I'll probably scuff a lot of this up, treat it, probably paint it, and then put plywood down. There's some areas that need attention. You can see the outside there that I'll get to later, but getting this plywood up is proven to be a chore. So I bought myself a big old tool to do it with today, to fix it today. And I'm gonna see how that son of a gun's gonna work. So just to go through a few of the things that I decided to do along the way. A lot of these bus projects, I guess it really depends if you're going to live in the bus or just kind of like party in the bus. is based on decisions that people do along the way, like taking the ceiling out to re-insulate and whatnot. I don't think I'm going to go through that because that is a major, that's a major undertaking with all of these, where are they? Right here, these rivets. They're a bitch to get out, and which also brought me to another decision that I made to not take these sidewalls out. You can see the sidewalls. It's just aluminum. This bus obviously is already insulated. So I'm gonna take that one panel out there, and I think I'm just gonna leave the rest because of the, there's already insulation there. And again, the rivets, a complete bitch to take rivets out. There's no good way to do it. Yesterday, I think I made the decision based on, well, my thumb right there, I don't know. You can't see, I smashed it. And that was the deciding factor of, that's gonna stay, because ultimately, this is gonna be the bedroom area here. Over the wheel wells, typically our closets, whatnot. Full kitchen. There's gonna be a full kitchen on this side. Countertop, sink, refrigerator somewhere, cooktop. Shower, there'll be a shower in here. Couch, chairs, I mean, you're gonna see it along the way, but this is another issue. These heaters that the old buses had, or they, I guess they probably still do, but you gotta do something with these. Antifreeze runs through these lines, through the heater, and then there was also a little fan. I don't think these have worked for years, but the antifreeze still runs through the lines, so that's gonna be an issue. For now, I'm just gonna drag them along the way to get them. Looking at needing. I'm also looking at needing a name for this bus. Everyone names their buses, and then along the way you kind of call it whatever the name is. I joined a discussion forum called Schoolie, S-K-O-O-L-I-E, which I guess that's what I am now. That's what people call themselves that make buses into motorhomes, campers, or permanent homes, whatever you have. But this one is basically going to be something to take fishing and sleep, Indiana football games, because my son is a Hoosier. So I'll be taking it to the games. One of my Facebook friends has already come up with the name the Hoosier Cruiser. Hoosier, I can't even say it, so I don't know that I can name it that. Hoosier Cruiser. So I'm gonna need some suggestions. Maybe you guys can help me out along the way. So that's gonna be it for today. Super Bowl Sunday. Why the hell am I out here anyway? But I'll be doing a lot of this, probably all of this work by myself, so bear with me. I'm hoping to have this thing Jambo ready, Jamboree in the Hills, third weekend in July, to have to throw the first party in it. And then from there on out, it's gonna be going to Indiana. So if anybody's ever thinking about doing a project like this, this demolition section really sucks. But this thing right here, this tool right here, is a must. It allows you a lot of leverage when you're working by yourself. And it tears shit up, as you saw. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned for future episodes. Again, I need some help naming this bitch, so I can cuss her out when I want to and call her by name. So thanks a lot.